We are about to bring up 10 banners, and these banners represent the 10 houses that Mother Clare Moore had a connection with. Mother Catherine McCauley brought Mother Clare Moore to the first house, and Clare was to found 9 other houses in her lifetime. So we begin with Bermondsey in 1839. Bermondsey was the first convent of mercy in England. Mother Catherine McCauley came with Sister Clare Moore and other sisters to begin it. The convent was built so close to the River Thames that it got flooded several times. And in March 1945, the original convent was destroyed by a bomb just 2 months before the end of World War II. Chelsea, 1845. St. Joseph's Convent, Chelsea, was opened by 5 sisters in 1845 as the first branch house of Bermondsey. In 1854, the Chelsea Convent offered hospitality to those Irish sisters who were on their way to the Crimean War. Sister Bernard Dixon of the Chelsea community volunteered to go with them. Several branch houses or foundations were established from Chelsea, including Brentwood in 1872. Bristol, 1846. In February 1846, 4 sisters went from Bermondsey to make a mercy foundation in Bristol, where they began a school. And in 1853, the sisters were given permission to visit patients in the Bristol Royal Infirmary. In 1896, the old convent was closed, and the sisters moved from there to the more spacious convent in Westbury-on-Trim. Brighton, 1852. Founded on the 11th of June, 1852, with 3 sisters from Bermondsey, they came to teach and to care for the sick and poor. In 1860, a bazaar was held in the Brighton Pavilion to help the poor, and it raised £600. In 1868, a convent was founded by Brighton in Guernsey in the Channel Islands. And in 1888, a branch house was also established in Midhurst in West Sussex. In 1854, a war began in the Crimea, which lasted for 2 years. And in October 1854, Mother Clare Moore and 4 other sisters set out to nurse the soldiers there. Mother Clare Moore became a great friend and support to Florence Nightingale. They kept up their friendship even after Florence had returned from the Crimea. It was after the sisters returned from the Crimea that Bishop Thomas Grant suggested the idea of a hospital. Great Ormond Street. So on returning from the Crimean War, Cardinal Wiseman asked Mother Clare Moore to staff a hospital in London for the long-term sick, poor. 5 sisters, led by Mother Gonzaga Barry, who had served in the Crimea, arrived at Great Ormond Street, London, in November 1856, beginning the Hospital of St. Elizabeth. This was London's first Catholic hospital since the Reformation, and the idea was to care for those incurables who were not welcomed in general hospitals. In 1898, the sisters built a new and larger hospital in St. John's Wood, which is still there today, St. John's and Elizabeth's Hospital. Wigton, 1857. On the 31st of August, 1857, four sisters set off north with Mother Clare Moore to begin this foundation. They called to Sunderland to see the sisters there for several days. This was the first house of religious women established in Cumbria since the dissolution of the monasteries by King Henry VIII. The sisters taught in the schools and ran an orphanage. Gravesend, 1860. The sisters dealt with a cholera outbreak in Gravesend, and the local doctor wrote, "Honour to whom honour is due. During the Crimean War, I read much about the Sisters of Mercy, but here in England, our own dear country, I witnessed the same." In 1942, seven sisters evacuated from Alderney in the Channel Islands during the war and joined the sisters in Gravesend. Abingdon, 1860. In January 1860, Mother Clare Moore brought three sisters to begin their ministry. The sisters became involved in education, visitation of the poor and needy, and the local workhouse. Bermondsey community continued to give help as several of the young sisters died of consumption. Clifford, 1870. The first Mercy Sisters in Clifford came from Dublin in 1855, but in 1867 they moved to Hull. So on the 21st of April 1870, four sisters came from Bermondsey to restart the convent. The community opened a school for girls and a night school for young women working in the flax mills. In 1971, the last sisters moved into their Doncaster house, and Clifford closed after 101 years of ministry in the area. And finally, Eltham, 1874. Bishop Dunnell asked Mother Clare Moore if the sisters would take charge of an industrial school for girls in Eltham in 1874. The building needed much cleaning and care to be fit for purpose. Mother Clare Moore was keen to establish a library for the girls and asked them to write and say what kind of books they liked. Sadly, Mother Clare Moore became very ill with pleurisy and died on the 14th of December, 1874. Just over 100 years later, in September 1984, St. Mary's School was moved from the High Street to Glenure Road, where it flourishes today.
It's a great honor for all of us to be here to give thanks for the wonderful life of the Mercy Sisters, but especially Mother Clare. What she did, how she helped, and the inspiration she was for so many. So as we begin, let us just pause for a moment and just ask the Lord for forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you called us to be a people of faith. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you inspire us always to be a people of hope. Christ, have mercy. And Lord Jesus, you send us to be a community of mercy. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
You might want to just sit down a little. On behalf of the Institute of Our Lady of Mercy, we would like to welcome you to this celebration mass of the 150th anniversary of the death of Mother Clare Moore and the founding of Eltham, which is the reason why we're here today. A special welcome to those who are joining us online across the country and across the world, especially our sisters in Kenya and Romania. We're grateful to Bishop Pat Lynch for agreeing to preside at the Mass, along with Bishop Paul Hendricks and Abbot Hugh Allen, the Vicar for Religious for the Diocese of Southwark. And a warm welcome to the priests who are concelebrating here, who have various connections with the Mercy family. Father Joseph, who's the MC at the Cathedral here, Canon Alan McLean from Bermondsey, and Canon Philip from Whitstable, Father Malaku and Father Tiziana, who are Comboni missionary priests. And we also welcome members of the chaplaincy team from Guy's and St. Thomas's. Reverend William Sharp is with us today, and sadly, Canon Mia Hilborn couldn't be with us because of her health. We also welcome Father Gildas, hospital chaplain, and Father Jake from Guy's and St. Thomas's. And I think there may be a few other priests who I'm not aware of, so I do apologize. So other bishops and clergy and friends who are connections with our Mercy family are unable to attend, but have assured us of their prayers. So we welcome our Mercy family here today on this historic occasion, a milestone in our history of mercy. We're delighted to have Sister Patricia, who's the CEO of Mercy International Centre in Baggot Street, and Sister Margaret Daly, who's responsible for the spiritual heritage at and the Heritage Centre at Baggot Street. And both sisters are originally from Cork, which is one of the houses that Clare Moore was involved in founding. We also have Sister Geraldine and some of the Union General at team here from Harewood Avenue, along with sisters from the various communities in London and Handsworth in Birmingham. We're delighted to have Sister Paula, the President of the Federation Sisters of Mercy, and sisters from Midhurst. And the sisters from Sunderland and Gravesend unfortunately couldn't be with us, nor could the sisters from Guernsey, but they may be watching online, so we hope you can be participating in this celebration mass. And we welcome our sisters from the Institute who've travelled from various communities here to celebrate, including our sisters from Bermondsey and Eltham. As Barbara has said, Mother Clare Moore was the first religious superior of Bermondsey. We're delighted also to have the Croydon and Bermondsey associates, and if there are any other associates from other places, you're very welcome. And lastly, but in no ways least, I'd like to thank the children and pupils of St. Joseph's School, Bermondsey, and St. Mary's Eltham, We're delighted that you can participate in this very special occasion with us today. And obviously there were great links with Mother Clare Moore, with your two schools and the area that you live in. So to anyone else who is joining us, you are very welcome. And when I was reflecting on this anniversary in the liturgy for today, I was struck by the words of the prophet Jeremiah, "I know the plans I have for you." And God has a plan for each of us before we are born. And how amazing it is to see how this plan for Georgiana Moore was to unfold because of her openness and willingness to trust where God would lead her. We might ask ourselves, what is God's plan for me, for us, today and into the future? She was born and named Georgiana on the 20th of March 1814, and her mother was widowed and she converted to Catholicism. And it was when she was 14 years of age she went to the House of Mercy in Baggot Street in 1832. She went there and became a governess, supporting the vision of Catherine Macaulay. And she was there encountering the servant girls who came there for refuge. And Catherine Macaulay and a small group of sisters started to welcome those women and girls into the house so that they could find some kind of rest and comfort and some education. So Catherine and her cousin and a companion were involved in hospital visitation and helping to meet the needs of the poor in Dublin. She also shared her faith through the teaching of the catechism to the young women. So this is where Clare Moore, who was known then as Georgiana, would have seen what Catherine was beginning to have as a vision for the House of Mercy in Ireland. And then at some point, Clare Moore decided to enter, and she was given the name Clare when she entered as a religious. So we are delighted today that so many of you can be here. I'm not going to go into a lot of the history because Barbara's actually said about the places that she founded, and we're delighted to have these beautiful banners here to show the places, and we have sisters here who are connected with some of the houses and the foundations. So hopefully after Mass you'll be able to enjoy a comfortable cup of tea and chat with the sisters there. So we're grateful to be here, and we thank God that we have this great woman who went before us and who shared and spread mercy through the areas of London and other places of the world, including the Crimea. Thank you.
Thank you, sister. And let us stand now as we sing the Gloria.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, the Father of every gift, all we have and are comes from you. Teach us to recognize the effects of your endless mercy and to love you with sincere hearts. And we ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. I know the plans that I have in mind for you. It is Yahweh who speaks. Plans for peace, not disaster. Reserving a future full of hope for you. Then, when you call to me and come to plead with me, I will listen to you. When you seek me, you shall find me. When you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me. The word of the Lord.
The second reading is from the correspondence of Catherine Macaulay. My dear Sister de Sales, I think sometimes our passage through this dear sweet world is something like the dance called Right and Left. You and I have crossed over, changed places, etc., etc. Your set is finished for a little time. You dance no more, but I have to go through the figure called Sir Roger de Coverley, too old for your memory. I'll have to curtsy and bow. In Burr, presently, change corners going from the one I'm in at present to another. Take hands of everyone who does me the honour, and end the figure by coming back to my own place. I then have a seesaw dance to Liverpool, and a mercy jig that has no step to Birmingham, and I hope a second to Bermondsey. When you and Sister de Sales, when you and Mary Xavier O'Connor and I will join hands and dance the Duval trio back on the same ground. We have one solid comfort amidst this little tripping about. Our hearts can always be in the same place, centered in God, for whom alone we go forward or stay back. Oh, may he look on us with love and pity, and then we shall be able to do anything he wishes us to do, no matter how difficult or to accomplish or painful to our feelings. If he looks on us with approbation for one instant each day, it will be sufficient to bring us joyfully to the end of our journey. Let us implore him to do so at this season of love and mercy. I am greatly comforted by the good account I hear of you. My poor old child says you are all comfort to her, for which God will bless you, as her place is very arduous and trying. Pray much for your affectionate Catherine Macaulay.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The King will say to those on his right hand, "Come, you whom my Father has blessed, take for your heritage the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you made me welcome. Naked, and you clothed me. Sick, and you visited me. In prison, and you came to see me." Then the virtuous will say to him in reply, "Lord, when did we see you hungry, or feed you, or thirsty, and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger, and make you welcome? Naked, and clothe you? Sick, or in prison, and visited you?" And the king will answer, "I tell you solemnly, in so far as you did it to the least of these brothers or sisters of mine, you did it to me." The Gospel of the Lord.
This year is a very special year for the Sisters of Mercy. A special year for the Sisters of Mercy in Bermondsey and the Archdiocese of Southwark, but also throughout the UK. On November the 19th, boys and girls, we will celebrate the arrival of the Sisters of Mercy in Bermondsey, and then on December the 14th, we will celebrate the 105th anniversary of the death of Mother Clare Moore. And in our Mass today, we give thanks for the person that she was, but also for the zeal and commitment that she showed in giving witness to God's love and mercy in so many different places and in so many different ways. As we have been told already, she was born in Dublin way back in 1814, and her father died when she was very young. 9 years later, however, her mother became a Catholic and continued to be an inspiring influence on the young Georgina, ensuring that she received a strong formation in her faith. And as a young person, she was inspired by the example and the witness of the helpers of Catherine Macaulay, who reached out and helped and provided practical support for many vulnerable women in the city of Dublin at that time. Catherine Macaulay recognized very quickly the human and spiritual gifts that Georgina had, and that she displayed them, and asked her to be a governess to her niece. Through her contact with Catherine Macaulay and the sisters, Georgina felt a strong call to become a Sister of Mercy. And after a period of ill health, she received the habit in 1832, and a year later professed her vows as a Sister of Mercy. Mother Clare's commitment, Mother Clare is how we now know her, and her dedication to being a living instrument of God's love and mercy was inspirational. First in the city of Dublin, then in Cork, but then in many other places, but especially here in Bermondsey. She went on to serve the soldiers in the Crimea, and finally, when she returned, she oversaw and supported the establishment of communities here in the UK. As was mentioned, she accompanied Catherine Macaulay as they opened the first convent of mercy outside Ireland here in Bermondsey. And Bermondsey was an inspirational choice for the first community. It was one of the first canonical parishes established in the UK after Catholic emancipation. In the early 1840s, the poverty and overcrowding in Bermondsey inspired the great novelist Charles Dickens, who wrote Oliver Twist, which many years later inspired the musical Oliver. And then in the late 1840s and the early 1850s, the situation in Bermondsey became even more challenging, with the arrival of thousands and thousands of families fleeing from the famine in Ireland. For individuals and families, the suffering and struggling, the Sisters of Mercy were truly a ray of light, giving practical help and assistance, visiting the sick at home and in hospitals, and especially being with families, especially after the death of a loved one. And then also providing an education for young people and children, and a home for orphaned children. Mother Clare was instrumental in founding communities throughout London and in Bristol and Brighton, and was the driving force for all that was done and achieved. As one bishop said of her, she was fit to rule a kingdom. However, as mentioned earlier, in 1854, Mother Clare began a new chapter when, with four other sisters, she set out to nurse the soldiers wounded in the Crimean War. And she was assigned to a hospital in Turkey, and it was there that Florence Nightingale came to know and be inspired by the faithfulness of the Mercy Sisters. Their dedication to the wounded, sick and soldiers, their dedication to prayer, and their dedication and faithfulness to being a community that gives concrete witness to God's mercy. Unfortunately, however, Clare became ill and had to return home. And Florence Nightingale wrote to her saying, "Your going is the greatest blow I have yet, but God's blessing and my love and gratitude go with you." In the most difficult of circumstances, Clare and the other sisters inspired many people by the way they lived out their mercy charism. When she returned to London and had fully recovered, she continued her inspirational leadership, overseeing the opening of other communities in London and beyond. Our readings today, boys and girls, sum up the compassion and courage that enabled Mother Clare and those early Sisters of Mercy to be truly a community of mercy during difficult times. In the first reading, Jeremiah reminds us and the people of Israel that it is God who helps us to truly see the suffering in the world. It is God who calls us to respond to the suffering in the world, and it is God who gives us the strength, the courage, and the compassion to help those who are suffering in our world. And that is what Catherine Macaulay does in her letter of December 1840. In today's gospel passage, Jesus also reminds us that we are judged not ultimately by the words we say, but especially by what we do, by how we reach out to those who are hungry and thirsty, by how we reach out to those who are sick and in prison, and how we reach out to those without a home and hope. Our prayer today, boys and girls, is especially one of thanksgiving. We thank God for Mother Clare, for her faith and her trust in God, for her deep compassion for those who were suffering, for her profound understanding of God's mercy, for her leadership and administrative skills, and for her enduring commitment to enabling the Sisters of Mercy here in London and the United Kingdom to truly be instruments of God's mercy in our world. And so we pray that she will continue to be at rest in peace with the Lord and continue to remember us in our struggles and in our work for God's love and mercy in our world today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And so for a moment, let us just reflect and then stand for our bidding prayers as we offer them to the Lord. Like a shepherd, the Lord continues to care for us. And so with confidence we pray.
For the Church, Pope Francis, Archbishop John, his auxiliary bishops Paul and Philip, all clergy, religious, teachers, parents and carers, that they will be blessed. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For Mother Clare Moore, on this, the 150th anniversary of her death, that her love for our foundress, Venerable Catherine Macaulay, may continue to inspire us all. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all who have supported our Mercy Ministries over many years, that they may be rewarded for their great generosity. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all who are poor, sick, homeless, hungry, deprived of education, exploited and abused women and children, needs which inspired Catherine Macaulay to found the Sisters of Mercy, and needs also dear to the heart of Mother Clare. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For peace and reconciliation. For peace and reconciliation in our war-torn areas of the world. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all our deceased sisters, families, benefactors, and friends, may they rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We unite our prayer with Mary, Mother of Mercy, as we sing together the Salve Regina.
God of all tenderness and compassion, listen to our prayers, spoken and unspoken. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Sisters and brothers, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us pray. Lord, may this offering of our love be acceptable to you. Let it be transforming and transform our lives and bring us your peace and mercy. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Holy God, we are yours for time and eternity. We give you thanks and praise for the wonders of your providence. From the womb of your mercy, all things came to be. Our universe, wild with possibility, our fragile humanity, and our longing for wholeness. From the fullness of your love, you sent us Jesus the Redeemer, the hand of our compassion outstretched to a broken world. Anointed by the Spirit, Jesus announced the good news of the poor, offered healing to the sick, and taught the word of life to all who longed for truth. And so with all creation, we praise and raise our voices in praise of the tenderness of your mercy as we sing. Holy God, we praise the splendor of your beauty. Your holy wisdom took flesh among us and entered our life of needs and limits, of passion and promise. With special love, Jesus made his home among us and among the poorest and the least, that they might know themselves as chosen ones, sons and daughters of God's promise. So now, Lord, pour out your Spirit upon these gifts and upon the people gathered here. Teach us the mystery of this bread and wine, that by our faithfulness to love and our works of mercy, we may transfigure this world. On the night before he died for us, Jesus gave us the great sign of his enduring presence in the world. He created a table of welcome where all people find a home. Those who are broken hear the word of hear the kind word, the gentle, compassionate look, and the patient hearing of sorrows. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we eat this bread and drink this cup, we long for the coming of God's reign, where misery is relieved and all people know their full dignity. Come, life-giving Spirit, and make us one body with Christ. Root us in God and draw us into deeper bonds of friendship and reconciliation, and empower us for mission. God, in your tender mercy, you have given us one another.
Fill your church with your spirit of compassion, so that knowing your mercy, we may be merciful ourselves. We pray for Francis, our Pope, John, our Archbishop, so auxiliary bishops, for all men and women who minister in your church, and those who seek to mend our broken world. Open us to contemplate your presence in one another and in our universe. Keep us in communion with those who, healed by your mercy, rejoice to sit at your table in heaven. Keep us in communion with Mary, who magnified your name among the poor, with Catherine Macaulay, who walked the way of mercy through the streets of Dublin, and with the women of mercy who have gone before us.
God of new creations, fill us with the courage to dream, and empower us for the work that makes these dreams real. Give us the patience we need for when we can only take short, careful steps. Keep us ever mindful of the dying and rising of Jesus, our companion and our friend, who walks before us on the way of mercy. In the midst of all our tripping about, may our hearts be always in the same place, centered in God. Make us delight in the hope that one day with Jesus, we will come to possess you, our God and our all, in your never-ending reign.
And so, through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And so with confidence, let us pray as Jesus himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Lord, you give us your body and blood in the Eucharist as a sign that even now we share your life. Draw us closer to you and help us to recognize you in all we meet. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
And now I'd invite Sister Bernie to give the thanks. So boys and girls, please sit down for a moment.
So don't worry, I won't keep you too long, but it is really important to say thank you. So 2 days before her death, on Foundation Day in 1874, the Bermondsey Annals record that Clare Moore spoke to the sisters, and it describes, looking at them with great tenderness, she, with great difficulty, said, "I am so grateful. I am so grateful for all your kindness to me, for all you have done for me, for all you have done for the poor." So it is in Clare's spirit of gratitude and on behalf of the Institute leadership team, I offer some heartfelt thank yous to all those who've contributed to today's celebration. Because as we know, an event like this just doesn't happen. An awful lot of thought and preparation and rehearsal goes into it. We'd like to thank the planning group behind the event, in particular Sister Barbara Jeffrey, who coordinated the group, Sister Jude Groden on the team, sisters from Bermondsey and Eltham communities, Institute Archivist Daniel Flint, and the secretarial staff at Yeadon, Jane and Geeta. They've done a terrific job. And thanks to all who've taken part in this beautiful liturgy. We'd like to thank our musicians, especially Francesca on the organ, and the children of St. Joseph's School in Bermondsey and St. Mary's School in Eltham, for singing so beautifully and for taking up the lovely banners for all the Mercy Foundations. We thank the teachers in both schools for the preparation you've done with the children before this Mass, and we thank their parents. And we hope you feel very proud today to be part of the Mercy family. We thank our celebrants here today, Bishop Pat Lynch, Bishop Paul Hendricks, Abbot Hugh Allen, Vicar for Religious, and Canon Allen, who, undeterred by recent surgery, has become part of this Mass. We also thank all their brother priests and deacons who join with them today, some coming long distances to be here, so thank you all very much. We thank the Cathedral Dean, Father Michael Branch, and all the staff at St. George's for enabling us to use this lovely building for our celebration. And as we've heard today, Clare Moore was a great support to the early bishops of Southwark, and no doubt she would have been very familiar with Pugin Southwark Cathedral, the predecessor of this current church. We thank all the Sisters of Mercy here today from Institute, Union and Federation, who've joined together to celebrate this wonderful Mercy Woman. And we thank the Mercy Associates who join us today, all the friends of the Sisters and those who are online. And in anticipation of the catering in Amiga Hall, we thank the staff who've prepared that for us, the refreshments. Finally, and most importantly, we thank God. We thank God for the gift of Clare Moore, for her legacy of service and compassion, which still inspires us today. In the words of Catherine Macaulay, may God grant us all a lively gratitude. Thank you.
Boys and girls, there is one group I would really like to say a big thank you to, and that's the Sisters of Mercy over many years here in this country. They have had a huge impact on your school and many schools and parishes, not only in the diocese, but also many people who are struggling. Can we give them a big, big thank you by congratulating them? Pope Francis says that there are three phrases we must never forget. Please, thank you, and I'm sorry. And very often we take them for granted. And Mother Clare, I'm sure when she was asking people to do something very difficult, she would have said, please. And when they did it, she would have said, thank you. But the last one to remember is that if you make a mess of it, do say, I'm sorry as well. So, boys and girls, you were wonderful. Let us stand now for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless us and keep us today and always. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.